Hello, and welcome back to our Egyptian campaign. And we are just about to face the Blemmyes
I am no one.
in battle. Prochoros has already
What can I
moved,
do for Egypt?
so it is up to Tlepolemus
I live to serve Pharaoh.
Agapios. Wait, what are you saying? You live to serve Pharaoh? You are the Pharaoh. Agapios. See, you go to faction. It's kind laggy. See, faction leader Agapios. All right.
How can I assist Pharaoh to battle?
Here we go.
My master will kill them all.
Look at that. This is going to be a fight. This is going to be quite a brutal battle. Battle of Medjay. It's appropriate. 262 BC. Right, so they got elephants. But we do have javelins, so the javelins will be able to knock out those elephants, no problem. I'm going to save them specifically for those elephants. And looks like they have missile superiority. They got way more archers. Yeah, we don't have much as far as range units. But we got a lot of cavalry, and we got a lot of pikes, and we got a lot of swords, and we got a lot of axes. So we are in a good position. You know, the troops we have are quality troops. They're not just like troops that are just thrown in. They are actually troops of very high quality that we are going to be using against the Blemmyes or Blemmyes. Blemmyes! You motherfucking bastards! The bastard Blemmyes. The sons of Maram. This is the same army that we fought before. It destroyed the last one. But this is a new army, the Radiant Obelisks. Figure new army will be able to suffice. They have reinforcements of 1660, the children of the sun and the heralds of Alatu. But we have the pride of Bost, 2100, and that is going to be very good. And the 2100 is made up of the same units that you can see here. We got the Galatian swordsmen, the citizen cavalry, we got the pikemen, we got the Carian axemen. We got Egyptian slinger, and then we got an Egyptian javelin. It's pretty standard boilerplate. We're the attacking army. They're going to be in phalanx. They're going to be behind.
Ready to march.
Carrying axemen.
Galatian guard.
I don't want the Galatian. I don't want my general.
Infantry ready.
I don't want my general on the flank. So I'm going to put them over here.
Citizen cavalry.
Citizen cavalry, I'm going to put over here. This is my other carrion axeman. I want him taking this spot. Galatian swordsmen, they'll do good in a fight, but they're not gonna do good as far as defense. Carrion axemen are just meant to hold the troops in place.
Warriors eager for blood.
calculations. Alright.
Citizen cavalry!
If we can keep this formation and move up, I believe we will be very successful. So, let's give it a shot. So, we got our troops. Battle of Medjay. Oh god, here we go. Alright, looks like they're running. I thought they were gonna hit us straight on, but I guess they won't. Alright, here we go. Oh shit. Oh shit! My men are getting chewed up. Come on, where are our javelin men? Javelin men, get your asses over here.
Our general is under attack.
See, I hate when they don't move. This is the only target I want you firing on. There's elephants. Come on, God. No, what the fuck are you doing? There we go. Now we're hitting them. Those javelins hit. Oh, look at all. They all died at the same time! Oh, shit! Alright, carry an axeman. Move up. Mercenary Sabaean spearmen. We're going to move up and engage that. Now that the javelin men are free, I want them to hit these Sabaean spearmen in the rear. And the Royal Guard can stay in the back. Slingers, I'll move up. Pikemen, I'll move over here. Carrion Axemen, I'll move behind them. Desert Cavalry, I'll send the... I can't believe I failed to see that coming. Where are my reinforcements? Over here. Alright. Should be quite a punch. Boom. Although now it's not a good idea to keep them there. Alright, we're gonna hit this desert cavalry. Actually no, let's hit these levy spearmen in the rear. We need to free up these men. If we can get these guys running, be set. Levy spearmen are moving up to attack. I guess I do have to fight them. Damn it. Oh, this is just a mess. No, I'm not gonna have them fight the noble guard. I'm gonna have them come over here. Pikemen can deal with this cavalry. All right. Carrion axemen. Engage. Ready. And ready. Engage. Yo. Battle ready. Our oars are set. Swords. Slingers. Yours to command. Take the charge. Ready and waiting. Pikemen. To advance. General back here. Actually, let's put him next to the slingers. This is Agapios. Alright. Bring the Royal Guard back. Okay. This is all free units. Let's use them to hammer into what this is. The only exception gonna be this guy. I want him over here. Now, pikes are moving up. Egyptian javelin men, Egyptian slingers, pikemen. Let's take a look at the tactical map so we can get a general idea of what's going on. So it looks like I've got these guys surrounded. Over here I got them surrounded. They're making a push right here with whatever this is, and we're holding them. So the battlefield is pretty scattered. I'm gonna free up my cavalry. I'm gonna send them up to attack these mercenary Sabaean spearmen. They're gonna break soon. I'm gonna have them hit the archers. Alright, enemy general's dead. Excellent. I'm gonna have them hit the cavalry. Alright. We're doing good. Alright, the Battle of Medjay is in progress and it is going quite smoothly. Citizen cavalry! For glory! For riders! Advance! Galatian guard! No, I'm not gonna get Agapios. Yeah, I'm gonna get Agapios involved. He needs to get some combat experience. We will darken the sky. There he is, right here. Oh, you can't see him from the back. There we go, right there in the blue. The white plume. That's Agapios. He's the leader of the entire Ptolemy faction. He's in combat. I'm gonna move up the slingers behind them. I'm gonna have them hit these archers. Alright, so everyone's doing good on that front. How is this mercenary Sabaean cavalry even still fighting? They're getting destroyed. Levy spearmen are routing. carrying axemen. I want to send north to attack the Sabine spearmen. Meanwhile, over here, it's just a gridlock. You've got pikes. Everyone's advancing on the cavalry. They're still fighting. Okay, you know what? They only have 17. This is ridiculous. I'm moving this force up. We're gonna hit this mass of troops right from behind. So we got our pikemen marching forward. Citizen cavalry. Quickly now. Advance at speed. Charge. Right through the breach. Now these archers are screwed. Look at that, yeah. Pretty much wiped out those archers. Oh, this is shaping up to be quite a fierce battle. I'm gonna move these guys into the gap over here. Egyptian slingers and pikemen are gonna move up. Actually, no, I'm gonna have the pikemen attack these Nubian cavalry. Because pikemen against cavalry, that's just a recipe for awesomeness. Depends on which side you're on. Okay, let's highlight all my boys to see how we're doing. Whoa, look at all this. Wow, they are completely wiped out over there. Okay. Here we have a gap. We're gonna flood in.
The enemy general is dead.
Okay, both of the enemy generals are dead. This is confirmed. Alright, so I got everything going well. Looks like most of them are pulling back.
Pikemen, recharge! By your command. Pikes, recharge! Swiss melee cavalry.
Alright, move the slingers in support. Alright, this is turning out to be a very, very good battle. Alright, time to just hit these tribal slingers and such. Where's my cavalry? Can't do anything about that. But this cavalry, I can use to strike back against the slingers.
Javelin men.
Alright. So just not for my purposes, but for your purposes, I'm showing you the tactical map. Over here is that large clump where we're winning. We got the slingers in support, and we got a battle line here, we've got a battle line here, and we've got a battle line here. And that is pretty much what's going on.
We serve the mighty Pharaoh.
Everyone's fighting someone. No, no, attack. Attack this cavalry over here. Alright.
Advance at speed! At speed!
Okay, they're doing their job. These pikemen are doing their job.
Melee cavalry.
This isn't even a fight anymore, it's a slaughter. And I'm not going to spend the game chasing off some tribal slingers. Nope, I'm going to bring my full force right back. So, this cavalry might follow me, but they'd be pretty stupid to. In fact, I'll just give them a unit of pikemen to prevent that from happening. Hitting them right in the rear.
Diamond formation. Withdraw.
Alright.
Galatian Royal Guard. By your command. Engage. Orders. Engage. Carrion axemen.
Alright, we got our carrion axemen.
Slingers.
Where is Agapios? I'm gonna pull Agapios back. Here he is, right here. There's Agapios. Yeah, he's gonna be safe in the back, because they've lost like about 30 men. That's a pretty decent chunk of men to lose. Alright. Everyone else seems to be fighting pretty well. Mercenary leopard warriors. No! Kill them! Wow, this is shaping up to be quite the battle. Oh, look at this dude. He got flipped. And that guy lost his head.
At your service.
All right. So we're charging back into the battle. Looks like we need him over here the most. So that's where I'm going to send him. Just look at this battlefield. This battlefield is just ridiculous. Look at the bodies. There's just piles and piles of men and swords and shields and elephants.
Carrion axemen.
Well, I have a unit of carrion axemen way the hell back here. Yeah, get them into combat. I've got the enemy desert cavalry retreating. I don't really know where to send these guys. The enemy general is dead. There were three enemy generals. Wow. And they're all dead. Well, serves them right. Now their army should be crumbling. I mean, they have no commander at all. Okay. Now just to clean up the final remnants. So we got these guys moving up over here. Oh boy. Melee cavalry ready. Great advance! Engage! Battle ready and eager! Move back here. So are we chasing, yeah, we're chasing them off the field, and looks like this unit is the very last one. So let's just select everybody, have them hit this one unit. They're like, no, please, no. I was hoping it'd be a little bit more punchier. But we need not do more. We have won the Battle of Medjay with minimal losses. We only lost 2,621 men. They lost 3,952. We got 3,873 kills to their 2,514. Aspeta, their general, is dead. Both of our generals, Tlepolemus and Agapios, are alive. And Agapios, remember, is our faction leader, so he's Pharaoh. So Pharaoh Agapios has proven himself in the Battle of Medjay. We're gonna just kill him. Look at, they got.
The gods guide my footsteps.
The road is clear to Ptolemais Theron, but we are so torn up. Alright, how long until we're supposed to, 4 turns. 3 turns for them.
We fight for you, my lord.
And we can recruit.
Come join our ranks.
Make up some of the troops that we've lost. Okay, here we need 2 more citizen cavalry, and we need javelin men, and then the rest you can just really make Galatian swordsmen, so everyone is set. So 6 turns, and we'll be able to march. You might be saying, well, that's letting the initiative go by, but I mean, look, I've tried to march on Ptolemais Theron before, and it just, no, did not work. But we are doing good, and I believe I'm going to end the turn here, and I'm actually probably going to end the video here. So when the next turn comes, I'm going to end this video, because the battle took up a lot of time. So, I'll just be able to start with a fresh new turn in the next episode. I hope you've enjoyed. This has been a pretty cool battle, I think. And both of our guys are alive. Poisoned wells, that's not good. But we have architectural advances now, which means we can upgrade our cities. But that's the only thing I'm going to do. I'm going to call it quits here. I hope you've enjoyed, and stay tuned for more. Have an awesome day.